transformation, a new evolution of the subtle element of space into air, and now into the element of fire, where it expands and evolves one step further into creating this manifest experience of this world. And next, dear one, the fire becomes water, and the water itself adds a tactile sensation. More solidity enters into the creative consciousness. The forms begin to manifest more fully in the awareness that you are. As the elements arrive, the elements change, creating again the fluidity, the structure of a form that changes, a form that is structured yet not limited nor confined. For the element of water allows freedom of movement, freedom of expansion, freedom to touch and unify itself with all of life around it more fully. For the element of water gives you the senses to perceive yourself within this world, to touch that which is invisible into a unified field of perception that has a tangible reality within you. Understand, dear one, that which you are is this manifestation of these forms occurring within you, for there is nothing separate from the consciousness that you are. The idea, dear one, that form and matter are separate is an illusion, as we perceive ourselves being spirit within matter, as we perceive the formless upholding the form, as we perceive the formless acting upon the form to create greater change. Often, dear one, the different layers of manifestation have been called supreme, for there have been ideas and beliefs that have identified further with one element or the other, stating that this is superior to that, stating that one must be idolized over the other. Yet in truth, all comes from the same source, and all is manifest in the same way, through constant change and development, through self-perpetuating growth. And now, dear one, the element of water dissects itself further, splitting up, manifesting itself in new way to become the material world, to become the form of earth. The water solidifies itself, breaks down itself, slows itself, changing its vibrational structure to solidify more fully into something tangible. And this, dear one, is what you see, the forms connecting themselves into an isolated object, the forms manifesting themselves into a structure that maintains its own rigidity, that maintains its own shape and boundary. This, dear one, is the primordial elemental qualities of Earth, giving itself structure and form, stability and identity, for the water itself is always changing, and the mind cannot grasp hold a sense of self in a world of constant change with no limited boundaries. And yet the earth element itself creates the boundaries and gives your mind identification with the world of form. That is why the subject of death scares the mind. For the subject of death means the removal first of the earth element, and with it comes our identification, comes our sense of security, comes our sense of purpose, our sense of being someone and something. And during the process of death, the elemental energies reverse themselves in an order of dissolution from the grossest back to the most subtle. And first, dear one, the earth element fades away, and going with it is the sense of smell, the sense of the forms of this world. For you see, dear one, it is the solid nature that brings form and structure and identification, and associated with it are certain qualities of our material body, including the senses. For the senses allow us to touch and taste this manifest world, to give ourselves a more interactive and dynamic experience of that which we are as the creative consciousness. And so as the earth element is removed, our senses begin to withdraw back into the creative consciousness. The gross element dissolves. Our sense of a solid self dissolves. Our tactile feeling of being within a body softens and lessens as we feel ourselves returning more to the fluid state of being, to the fluid state of water. And now, dear one, as the water element regresses, dissolving further back into a subtler manifestation, it becomes the light of perception, it becomes the fire element, it becomes the expression and radiance of that which we are, the movement energy, the rising upwards. And now, the gross level of water has returned to a more subtle state of being, in which new qualities are exemplified and older states of identification have been removed. We find our perception of ourself changing as the embodiment of the material forms is dissolving and returning to a more subtle state. And now, dear one, our awareness continues to retreat back within the material forms. From fire we return to water, to air. From air we experience ourselves in a spacious state, in a state of being, a state of expansiveness, a state in which the subtle identity of the physical form has reduced itself even more, in which we find ourselves simply movement, touching and feeling the spacious quality of life, reaching out, and yet having less confined boundaries. For we ourselves have become more with the motion, more with the fluidity between each breath, the breaths between the forms, the motion and rhythm of life. And then, dear one, the qualities reduce further, and we become aware of ourselves as the spaciousness that we are. The movement has ceased. The change has diminished. And we find ourselves in a simple state of suspended animation, a state of stillness in which our awareness remains and yet no activity arises. We find ourselves in the experience of space. We are still self-aware, and yet the forms and shapes of the world as gathered through the five senses have reduced themselves down to nothing. Nothing but this, the spaciousness of that which we are. For it is within the spaciousness that all forms have arisen, and it is within the spaciousness that all forms will retreat. And yet we ourselves still exist. We ourselves still exist through this period of changing manifestation. We ourselves as awareness continue to exist, evermore, being as we are. And what, dear ones, what comes next after the experience of manifestation dissolves back into the spacious quality? Well, that is up to you, dear one, for you will make a decision, you will make a choice of where you wish to place your perception now that it has been removed from the material experiences within the physical world. For your physical body will still remain, yet your awareness will have removed itself from being contained within a world experienced through the senses. And as the awareness retreats, the energy from the senses is withdrawn, and you find yourself simply existing more fully as you, as a creative intelligence with self-awareness. And now, dear one, the choice is yours. For as you open your eyes and perceive the world around you, you will find yourself existing within a plane of existence that you desire to create. Do you wish to continue your awareness upon this earth? Do you wish to continue awareness within the room of your passing, maintaining yourself in this place more fully, to stay connected to your earthly existence?